name is Drew Schneider. I'm the simulation education specialist for CNM. Often when we talk about teaching methods, we often think of like the old classroom. Simulation is different. We take everything that you've known so far, we put you in this situation, and then we do a debriefing afterwards and see where you're at. It's really important to have trained simulation techs just because of the complexity of the simulation when we're trying to create high realism. The high-fidelity manikins that we have at CNM have a wide range of features, where we have the young kids all the way to the adults, the maternal, the birthing manikins. In addition to the technology where you can imitate physiology or pathophysiology, having this patient interaction is really important. We have 6 care rooms here at main campus. What we're able to do here is the video capture system and our one-way mirror windows allow us to have the simulation operations specialist sitting down, running the manikin, and being the part of the patient with the headphone on, so it is a live patient interaction. In terms of having trained SIM educators, there's things that the SIM educator needs to know how to do, such things as conducting a good debriefing. And the debriefing is where we go and we talk about either performance gaps or issues with knowledge. We go through this process, we get to make sense of this particular clinical experience that has happened. The CNM SIM team has a lot of experience running all different types of simulation from different groups and being able to meet the needs of different programs and their learning objective. Really, one of the biggest benefits for external clients is really the cost savings. To run a SIM center, it's really expensive. Having the ability to come to a place, have people to help you develop effective simulation that allows people to come in and say, we know we're gonna have a good training outcome.